talk about life imitating art, way after he'd filmed that, it was in fact a couple of weeks ago, Warwick and his family were at a garden centre, and the manager came over and recognised him, and she said, "Oh, we're having a Christmas bazaar here, and we've got a Santa. We wonder if you want to be a guest of honour." And he went, "Yeah, sure." And she went, "Can you bring your elf costume?" Like, every dwarf's got an elf costume. It's handed out.
See, that's
at
so
dwarf
bad.
School. Of course. But that's it, and people don't...
If there was anyone else who was struggling with something, you wouldn't say it in an equivalent to them if you saw someone
else... Of course
else.
Not. But people don't realise, they don't realise what they're doing, and he's cool
they
with
think
that.
Actually,
he knows.
That little, that's what he would like. That probably made his day off from a bit of work.
Of course. They don't know they've made a faux pas. You know, there's so little known about, you know, what's the politically correct term, for example. Some people still say midget. Now,
yeah.
That's a no-no. They call that the M-word.
Did that? I didn't realise.
Yeah, no. And in America, it's more militant. I mean, that's a dreadful
really?
Thing to say, yeah. And they don't like dwarf in America. They think that's insulting. Here, dwarf is fine, as long as they are a dwarf, because there's loads of different types of, you know, dwarfism, and, you know, little people is a generic term. So, you know, it's a minefield, which we play with in the show.
Yeah.
And Warwick's told me that in some cultures... they're considered lucky to touch little people. So he's had Japanese...
Ireland, leprechauns.
Whoa, and Japan, he's had
really?
Japanese tourists just rubbing up against him.
Right?
Yeah, and he wants to go, "I know what you're doing. I know what you're doing." He's also told me that he's had conversations with people that first met him, and he can tell, just in normal conversation, they're trying to avoid... words like little, small, tiny. They're actually, he sees them struggling to not say those words. So, once again, it's we're laughing at that middle-class angst. Just like we were laughing when David Brent went over and spoke to the only black guy in the office saying, "My favourite actor is Sidney Poitier." You know?
Well, what cameos have we got in there then to look forward to? Other than that? Do we know everyone is going to be in there? Are there still some surprises?
Yeah, no, the first episode is Liam Neeson. One of the most excruciating cameos we've ever done.
Really?
Oh, it's quite incredible. It takes up, I'd say, 50% of the blooper reel on the DVD, because we couldn't do it. Because Liam Neeson...
And he's a charming, lovely guy. What
he's amazing.
He's such a nice
guy. He's amazing,
guy.
Right? But he is like our John Wayne.
Yeah.
He's, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
he's the coolest,
huge,
most serious man. He's John Wayne.
Yeah.
Never the trivial stuff.
I've never seen him play anything for laughs.
Exactly.
Or...
Oscar Schindler, you know, Rob Roy, you know, Taken. You know. And he comes in and he sits down and he's like a foot from me. And he says, "I'm thinking of doing some comedy. Stand up, crazy characters." And I go, "All right." And he goes, "Let's do some improvisational comedy." And it's excruciating. And the joke is that he's terrible at it. That it's so inappropriate. Every subject we do, it just goes the worst, most depressing place you can imagine. And so that's ep one. Ep two is Johnny Depp. Incredible. I mean, amazing.
How do you even approach... I know he's a fan of British comedy and he loves your stuff and like the Far Show as well. What, do you email someone? Like, do you go to the official channels?
I just emailed him.
So he's at Hotmail 100, JDep 500
I said, "Sorry about the Golden Globes. how would you like to get your own back?" And he went, "Don't worry about it one jot." He said, "It was a privilege to be insulted by you at the Golden Globes." He really gave us Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
You know, this crazy bohemian self-centered method actor. And the thing with Johnny Depp is that he's in a new Tim Burton movie called Rumpelstiltskin, and so he wants to get into the mind of a dwarf. So Warwick is hired, and then Warwick just drops in that he's gonna, you know, drop in, and Johnny Depp goes, "Ricky Gervais, can I come?" And he comes along, and again, it's quite excruciating. He tries to, you know, tear me down for the Golden Globes. And it's just, we put out a clip and a lot of people thought it was real.
Yeah, I saw the comments. People were like,
they,
you know,
really
I can't
thought,
believe that that they've filmed this. It's terrible.
I know, yeah, yeah. Filmed with all those angles.
And lights and
stuff. Yeah. Oh, dear. Oh.